ओके सो दिस कुशाल शाह, इसने बहुत क्वेश्चन पूछे. डियर
हाँ
रेडियो क्लब, आई एम इमेंसली थैंकफुल टू यू, यू आर वेलकम. अ कॉम्पिटेंट इकोनॉमिस्ट वर्सेस अ पॉपुलर लीडर,
हाँ
इन जनरल हु शुड होल्ड द पोजीशन ऑफ फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर?
सी मेरा ओके हाँ सी द थिंग इज दैट व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू टेल यू वाज दैट फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर्स इन मोस्ट ऑफ द नेशंस आर पॉलिटिशियंस एंड दे आर नॉट इकोनॉमिस्ट्स द वे द नेशन सॉल्व दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम इज दैट दैट दे ऑलवेज हैव एन एडवाइजर और एन एडवाइजरी कमिटी व्हिच इज मेड ऑफ कॉम्पिटेंट इकोनॉमिक एंड दैट इज हाउ इट वर्क्स सो द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर इफ ही हैज सम बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग of economics then that is considered as fine as long as he takes the advice of the advisory committee but I'll give you one example Pranav Mukherjee was not a very good economist and Pranav Mukherjee was the finance minister and that time Manmohan Singh was the prime minister and the problem that Manmohan Singh had with Pranav Mukherjee was that Manmohan Singh was a very expert economist but Pranav Mukherjee would not listen to him So then finally it played this particular thing that they made Pranav Mukherjee the president of India. And then Pranav Mukherjee was very happy to be president of India rather than finance minister of India. And hence, finally, the economy once again came back in the hands of the people who knew economy. But usually a good finance minister is a finance minister who listens to the economists who has an advisory committee. Ha, that's how it works.
लेकिन वो सीट पे किसी इकोनॉमिस्ट को ही क्यों नहीं बिठाते थे, कोई अच्छा इकोनॉमिस्ट हो
सके? नॉट ऑल गुड इकोनॉमिस्ट आर पॉलिटिशियंस
अच्छा
एंड पीपल हु गो इनटू पॉलिटिक्स दे वांट द पोर्टफोलियो ऑफ फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर बिकॉज इट इज एन एक्सट्रीमली प्रेस्टिजियस पोर्टफोलियो दैट्स व्हाई Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now about 1991. बहुत बड़ा क्वेश्चन है. I request you to tell us what exactly happened in 1991. The type and the magnitude of economic reform. Do you think, as mentioned by Vivek Debroy, this was the reform where only the central government was party of concern? States had no role to play, and hence. So the reforms had a major impact. They were easy to implement.
Okay. So he is trying to say that the 1991 reforms were basically the center's responsibility. Is that what he's asking? Yes. Okay. The answer is yes, of course, because it was privatization and liberalization. So giving the businesses in the hands of the private sector is something which is always decided by the central policy. It is not something which is decided by state policy. And as far as globalization was concerned, opening up the international border for trade is always the responsibility of the central government. The state government does not have any portfolio about these things at all. So yes, of course, it was completely central decision. And it is center's responsibility only. The states do not come into picture for this.
Acha.
I'll just switch on the tube light there because I'm becoming dark. So just one sec.
Acha.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry.
It's okay, man.
Huh.
So, states have many welfare schemes to fund and project to carry out. Often,
yes.
It has been seen that all major projects starve due to lesser allocation of revenues, and of course, the quality of welfare
yes.
schemes is poor. Do you think states
yes.
should have a bigger say as far as redistribution of revenue is concerned? Should the center having a more global view? Exclusively control all major projects and the responsibility of states should be relaxed.
Okay. There is something called Finance Commission. And Finance Commission decides how much of the center's money should go to different states. And Finance Commission decides this based on welfare schemes, based on what is needed by different states and things like that. And then it is given. But the fact remains that states are too many and hence none of them get very huge share. But the center is center, so it has far more control over the resources. So center always will be able to implement schemes which are far larger compared to the states. And that's why whenever states feel that their finances are going haywire, they ask center to help them out. And then the Finance Commission decides whether they should be helped out or not. So there is a proper setup over there, but it is all political finally. किसी को ज्यादा देंगे किसी को कम देंगे क्योंकि मेरे सरकार की मेरी पार्टी की गवर्नमेंट वो स्टेट में है तो आई विल मेक श्योर दैट दैट स्टेट गेट्स मोर एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट सो फाइनेंस कमीशन डज वन थिंग पॉलिटिक्स प्लेज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट गेम्स सो दैट्स हाउ इट इज
अच्छा अच्छा बट कोई ऑब्जेक्शन नहीं उठा था लाइक अगर कोई स्टेट में समझ लो कांग्रेस की है सरकार उन्होंने कुछ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट से कुछ डिमांड की देन अगर कांग्रेस की सरकार वहां पे है तो ऐसा समझ के वो पूरी पूरी डिमांड उनकी एक्सेप्ट नहीं की देन कोई तो ऑब्जेक्शन उठाएगा कि क्यों एक्सेप्ट नहीं
मिनिस्टर शाउट्स एट द टॉप ऑफ हिज और हर वॉइस ममता बनर्जी हैज बीन सेइंग दिस फॉर सो लॉन्ग दैट वी आर गिविंग स्टेप मदरली ट्रीटमेंट दिस दैट लेकिन उससे क्या वो चिल्लाए तो चिल्लाए नहीं पैसा देना है तो नहीं देगा मोदी Center. तो नहीं मिलेगा पैसा दिस इज द ट्रुथ
सो इसके पीछे पॉलिटिक्स भी होगा ना बिकॉज
पॉलिटिक्स भी है पॉलिटिक्स प्लेज अ मेजर रोल यस 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 यस
बट देयर इज अ स्टेट वेयर द कांग्रेस पार्टी इज रूलिंग एंड द पीपल केम टू नो दैट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कांग्रेस पार्टी रूलिंग द बीजेपी इज नॉट गिविंग द इनफ फंड सो इन द नेक्स्ट इलेक्शन दैट पीपल वुड नॉट वोट फॉर द कांग्रेस पार्टी एंड दे विल गो फॉर बीजेपी कि वो लोग ऐसा सोचेंगे कि बीजेपी अगर आ जाती है तो जो भी डिमांड्स होंगे वो मीट होंगे वो एक्सेप्ट करेंगे कुछ अपोज नहीं करेंगे इजीली सब कुछ हो जाएगा तो एक पॉलिटिक्स
इतना ज्यादा हमारे लोग सोचते नहीं है तो इसलिए दिस इज ऑल विशफुल थिंकिंग
सो आई वाज आस्किंग Multiple sources have alleged that our condition is worse than 2008. India was already passing through an NPA crisis. Now that the industries, especially airlines, have received a major blow, would we see a massive NPA explosion coming soon? If so, how dangerous would it be? Has India faced anything of that scale in past?
We don't know. Times are so uncertain.
So I was asking multiple sources have alleged that our condition is worse than 2008 India was already passing through an NPA crisis now that the industries especially airlines have received a major blow would we see a massive NPA explosion coming soon if so How dangerous would it be? Has India faced anything of that scale in past?
We don't know. Times are so uncertain. What is going to happen? But the later we open, the more drastic will be the consequences.
In 2020, अच्छा, means he don't know, जिसने question पूछा है, कि when did he hear in childhood,
in 2020 India will become a superpower, and then the person who predicted this eventually died. He didn't predict for years after 2020, not intended to spread fear or rumor. But isn't it interesting to know how can India become a superpower in this situation?
India cannot become superpower in this situation, and India is not going to become a superpower. As simple as that.
Yes. बहुत साल लग जाएंगे उसके लिए तो.
We are the ones who have been brought down to our knees. Forget about becoming a superpower. Right now we are not able to even survive. So superpower is the बहुत बात हो गई.
Ma'am, I have a question. So the thing which I've observed in our college that many of our professors are very well experienced, not even in that, but in their field also, jo life mein kaafi cheeze kaam aati hai, right? So I've now not seen a single person jo student like professor ke paas gaya ho aur kuch aisa life related question pucha ho. Like ye, I have also realized this in the past 2 months in my internships. So I have never asked such a question to any the professor. So I want to ask that in your journey of life, have you do you want to share any incident which can inspire us or jisme se humko kuch seekh mil sake?
The incidents which will inspire you, I'll have to think about it.
Students ko.
हाँ नहीं, लेकिन मुझे अभी एकदम अचानक से तुरंत याद नहीं आ रहा है वैसे. आई हैव टू थिंक अबाउट इट एंड गेट बैक टू यू.
सो एनी एडवाइस यू वांट टू गिव टू स्टूडेंट कम्युनिटी जो आपको लगा हो कि यहाँ पे ये एडवाइस मिलती नहीं है स्टूडेंट्स को, या फिर यहाँ पे थोड़ा लैग कर रहे हैं, या ये चीज इनको पता हो तो अच्छा कर पाए. सो एनी काइंड ऑफ लाइक दैट एडवाइस.
My advice to the students is that they should concentrate on the studies, and if you are attending the classes and concentrating on studies, you will get good marks. I mean, it is as simple as that. There is nothing more to it than that. So, it's so very simple.
It's very difficult to convince the student community about this go regularly on lectures. Because,
I know.
Sorry, not, no offense, अगर मुझे भी कोई ऐसा बोले तो मेरे लिए भी डिफिकल्ट होगा वो एडवाइस को ऐसे एक्सेप्ट करना. सारे लेक्चर्स अटेंड.
लेकिन जब तक वो नहीं होगा तब तक फिर कुछ नहीं होगा. इस वे द प्रॉब्लम इज.
वो भी है, लेकिन मींस देयर आर मेनी स्टूडेंट्स हु डोंट रेगुलरली अटेंड लेक्चर्स बट स्टिल दे स्कोर गुड. Means good marks, good grades. Means ये देखा है मैंने, observe किया, इसलिए बोल रहा
हूँ. Correlation needs to be worked out. I'm not too sure whether that correlation is very high. That if you don't attend lectures and you get good marks, how many of them are there? It needs to be actually looked into. The correlation.
It depends on the students also. Like my own roommate was very good in mathematics and physics and all that subjects. He don't used to attend any lectures, but still managed to get a very decent scores in all those subjects of mathematics and physics and all. So, ma'am, in the last interview which I took 1.5 years before, you told me that RI rural internship was started around 5 years ago, since 2013 ki aaspas, right?
Ha.
So, what was the motivation behind starting this rural internship?
No. Rural internship didn't start in 2013. Rural internship was always existent in DICT for as long as I remember. Yeah. Definitely. Since the day I joined in 2009 January. And since then, rural internship has always been there. It's just that it was in the hand of somebody who was not looking at it in a serious manner. And then after passed on to other professors, they started taking it very, very seriously, because it is supposed to be one of the important features of, unique features of DICT. So maybe from 2013, I don't remember the year, but maybe from 2013 onwards, it went into the hands of the professors who were taking it far more seriously. So that's the thing. For that also it existed, but it wasn't really implemented very well.
So ma'am, it's just a suggestion. So when I completed my rural internship, I asked the many students that how were their experience in the rural internship. So, almost many people said that their experience were good, but there were also some people that aisa bolte the ki nahi hota to acha hota, like, right? So you should like circulate a form after the rural internship gets ended that how was your experience, how can we improve, kahan kahan humko dhyan rakhna chahiye and all. So idea is ki kya kya face kar rahe hain.
Yes, I will pass it on to Professor Yash Vasauda.
Please.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Yeah. And this question next. Ankit Chawla. Why did you actually leave the college? We were hinted that you got hired by an A-League college. Is it true? And if yes, what's the name of the college?
Oh, I will tell you. I was telling the name of the college from the very beginning. I think the class that I was teaching, they know the name of the college because I told them everything. Okay, the reason why I left was because they offered me the position of Dean Research. And MIT, I am right now in MIT University, Mumbai. And MIT is a university. So I was asked to look after some 14 different schools of MIT University. And I was supposed to be doing research, I mean, guiding research for those people. So it sounded very challenging and it was a very high post, which I would never get as far as DICT is concerned because I'm not an engineer. So that's why I decided to move. So that was the reason why I decided to move. But I don't know. I am on 1 year lien. And for all you know, I am back in December. I have not left DICT. I have not resigned from DICT. I am just on 1 year lien. 1 year unpaid leave. That's all that is there. So there is still a very big possibility. We are already into May. And let me tell you, till now, MIT has not convinced me that I should continue over here. So by December, for all you know, I might decide ki chalo, bas ho gaya. Abhi deanship, pension, sab theek tha. Abhi wapas DICT chalte hain.
Achha, so ye aapne और अच्छा न्यूज दिया है DICT के स्टूडेंट्स के लिए, स्पेशली फर्स्ट सेकंड एंड थर्ड ईयर. मींस मैंने ये सुना था काफी स्टूडेंट्स से कि आपने कॉलेज छोड़ ही दिया है, अब आप वापस नहीं आने वाले, आपने कोई और कॉलेज ले लिया.
आई हैव जस्ट गॉन ऑन अनपेड लीव फॉर 1 ईयर. इवन इन माय फेसबुक पोस्ट आई हैड रिटन दैट. आई हैड रिटन दैट इन माय फेसबुक पोस्ट आल्सो व्हेन आई सेड दैट आई एम गोइंग. With that, I had written that I'm going just on 1 year leave and then I will decide.
Achha. Actually, nowadays people don't use Facebook a lot. That's why.
Pata nahi hoga. I know. Of course.
Okay, ma'am. So, I think we should end this session.
Yes, because it's already 7:30.
Yeah.
And so, ma'am, guys, thanks a lot. Nice talking to you. And suggest that if you have any questions, then you still send it to me. But I do not look at DICT webmail all the time. So that's why what I suggest is that send the message to alka.parikh@yahoo.in. And I will answer all those economics questions that you have in mind. And we will have a nice chat about these things. Okay?
Awesome. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for joining us. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
ऐसे तो और बातचीत करनी थी.
वंडरफुल चैटिंग विद यू ऑल.
थैंक यू मैम.
यस, बाय
बाय मैम.
बाय.